welcome to another edition of Quick Trivia with Mike. I know you've all been watching for a couple of weeks now, but I hope you're enjoying it as much as we're enjoying putting it on for you. I'm your host, Mike Brever. We always have a lot of fun, and we got a lot of very, very interesting things set up for you today. Usually, you know, I've been starting this program with a book that you can find in one of our libraries here. A couple of history books I've brought down, some books about my own Irish culture I've brought in. Hopefully you've had a lot of fun looking for them in the libraries and maybe taking them back and reading them. Today I've got a little bit special item for you today. All of you know that for the last probably 6, maybe 7 weeks now, the treasure chest has been closed. You residents that work in it and you residents that love to shop in it, you've had nothing that you've been able to enjoy over the last 6 or 7 weeks. I thought I'd bring you a little bit of a sampling of some of the new things that we have in the treasure chest so that when we reopen, you'll have a head start on other people that haven't been watching Quick Trivia with Mike right here on ECTV channel 955. The first items that we have in the treasure chest that I know you're gonna love, we've had a lot of people donate some CDs to us lately. All CDs in the treasure chest are $1. You can go down and find any you want. Some of the newest additions, we have Vivaldi here. I have a wonderful a CD of Beethoven piano concertos that I just know you're going to love. We have Rachmaninoff, 15 of his greatest masterpieces. You're gonna love this one. And again, my favorite actually, 7 symphonies from Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. You're going to love these CDs, and this is just a brief sampling. We've got about 50 of them downstairs right now that you're going to really love. Another new item that came in recently, who wouldn't love this? This is it's not crystal. It is a glass decanter, wonderful for your wine or your brandy or something like this, donated by a great friend of East Castle Place, $10. Who can beat a deal like this? This would look wonderful on your buffet or in a china cabinet, filled up with your favorite liqueur. I know you'd love it. Things like this are down there. We also recently got a donation of bookends. Obviously, these came from somebody's travel. You see, we have 2 of them. They're carved out of stone. Just a wonderful little knickknack that you can have on your shelf to hold your books together. It expands your library and it's very, very quaint. I know you're going to love it. So these are just a couple of the things. I know you're all wondering, when is the treasure chest going to open again? I'm not sure. The treasure chest is going to open again when it's safe for you and for our resident volunteers who host the treasure chest. It's going to be at least several weeks, maybe a month as well yet. Now, we don't want you to miss out on all these wonderful deals. The station management of ECTV channel 955 is considering a spin-off show of Quick Trivia with Mike. Many of you know that I used to work at Milwaukee's PBS affiliate, channels 10 and 36. You probably know they used to have an annual program called the Great TV Auction. Station management right here is looking at doing something like that in the treasure chest. Go down there with our cameras, show you some of the wonderful things we have. We're working on the format right now, and it's going to be another week or two yet till that's going to be airing on your airwaves here, but you're going to love it, and I hope you tune in. Now, let's get right to quick trivia. You remember that last week, we had a 3-list question for you. However, before I give you the answers to those questions, we have a couple of bonus questions for you today. They're not really tied into the bottle of wine that we have for you, but they are bonus questions that I hope you have a little bit of fun with. First of all, was the lead-in music for today's program. It's the first time we've had what we call bumper music. I hope you enjoyed it. I wonder if any of you know where that came from. It was made very famous by a Disney movie. If you can figure out the movie and even the score that we placed on that, you will be the person who can brag about the fact that you figured it out. The second bonus question I have for you today, again, it's not part of our actual award prizes, but it came from Jim Fry. He is a weekly player on Quick Trivia with Mike. He sent me a question last Friday that I'm not throwing in with the prizes because it wouldn't be fair to Jim. He wouldn't be able to participate in this, but it's a great question and I have to give Jim all the credit in the world. He sent me this question as a challenge to me, and I'm going to challenge you. Which U.S. presidents shared a family name, and what was the relationship between them? The example that he gave me was, if Hillary Clinton had won the presidential election in 2016, she and Bill Clinton would have shared a family name, and the relationship between them was husband and wife. How many other situations like that that actually became presidents are there in American history? You can put on your thinking caps with that one. Jim gave us a really, really good question. There's a trick component to it. I'll caution you about that. So put on your thinking caps and see what you can come up with. I'd like to welcome our new player this past week. We had a new resident throw an answer out, Arlene Brackensick. All of you that are going to be first-time players, we'll try to mention you because we're very proud of the fact that this is the highest-rated show on Channel 955, and we want to keep it that way. So keep tuning in and keep calling in with your answers. Now, first of all, you remember we wanted to know that at the beginning of the country, everybody who lived here had been born as a subject of the crown. They were all British citizens. The first question we asked was, who was the very first president who actually was born in the United States? By definition, that means the president had to have been born after the country was formed. We had many suggested answers to that. John Tyler was the most common wrong answer. The correct answer, however, was Martin Van Buren. Martin Van Buren was the eighth president of the United States. He served from 1837 to 1841. He was born in 1782, after the foundation of the United States of America. So Martin Van Buren was your correct answer on that one. The second question that we had for you was, what were the three towns that merged in 1846? To become the city of Milwaukee. The three towns were actually named after their original founders. Solomon Juneau came to the Milwaukee area in 1818, Byron Kilbourne came in 1837, and George Walker came in 1835. As you remember, Milwaukee was formed as a city in 1846. The three cities were Juneau Town, Kilbourne Town, and Walker's Point. That was the correct answer. The third question we had for you had to do with pandemics. In 1949, the United States was suffering through a polio epidemic, and it tremendously affected the children in the United States. Children became the face of that pandemic because so many of them were stricken. Children in iron lungs, struggling to breathe, wondering if they would be able to walk again normally, became the face of that epidemic. In 1949, a young teacher named Eleanor Abbott invented something that was meant to create a sense of whimsy, an ability to reach out into a world of imagination, specifically for children. We mentioned to you that on the very first the very first type of this invention, there actually was a graphic of two children playing. One of them was a little boy who wore leg braces to indicate that he had had polio previously. What was it that Eleanor Abbott invented in 1949 because of the polio epidemic? It was the game of Candyland. Candyland was invented in 1949 to create a sense of freedom and mobility in children everywhere. Ironically, Eleanor Abbott came up with the idea for this because she too was a polio sufferer. Shortly after the polio epidemic ended, Milton Bradley picked up the game of Candyland from Abbott. And to this day, Candyland is one of the most popular children's games that there is. Our winner from this past week, someone who got all three answers correct, I'm extremely impressed, Teresa Sundberg. Teresa is going to be winning the bottle of wine. I believe it was a bottle of Pinot Grigio. We'll be delivering that later today. And congratulations to Teresa. She's now a two-time winner, so we hope you all put on your thinking caps and provide a little bit of a challenge here. Now let's move on to this week's trivia questions, shall we? We've got a couple of them for you that we think are really, really interesting. First of all, let's return to Milwaukee trivia. Down by the lakefront, probably about 15 or 20 years ago, there was an extension put on the Milwaukee Art Museum. Many of you know that the Milwaukee Art Museum is frequently called the War Memorial Center. My question to you is, what was that addition to the Milwaukee Art Center called? Put on your thinking caps. It's a very prominent thing down there right now. It was the addition to the Milwaukee Art Museum. What is it called? My second question for you today returns us to a little bit of presidential trivia. I hope you all had fun with the questions last week. This one, it requires just a bit of explanation. Before President Trump, which president was our richest president? Now, I'm going to point out that you have to take these dollars and put them into 2020 dollars. You have to make believe that the president was alive today and his money equated to 2020 dollars. I have three samples for you. Was it John F. Kennedy? Was it Franklin Delano Roosevelt? Or was it George Washington? In 2020 dollars, which of these gentlemen was the richest president before President Trump? Now, the third question I have for you today involves a little bit of history also. If you're a fan of the space program, you're probably familiar with the term, Houston, we have a problem, or Houston, we're circling the moon, or Houston, we're about to land. That's because NASA is actually located in Houston. You all know that the space shuttles and the Mercury and the Apollo spacecraft took off from Cape Canaveral in Florida. But the actual administrative center where they track all of that is done at NASA in Houston. An interesting point of fact is that by a fluke of fate, it was almost in Cambridge. You could have had astronauts saying, Cambridge, we have a problem. Cambridge, we're about to land on the moon. Cambridge, we're returning to Earth. Why is NASA located in Houston and not in Cambridge? What event in history turned around where NASA is located? Well, there you have it, folks. Those are our three questions for today. To get in your answers, you can go to the front desk, to the concierge, write on a piece of paper with the three answers, ask who's ever at the front desk to put it into my mailbox. Please put the date and the time down that you turned it in, because the one with the most answers correct is the automatic winner. But if there's a tie for the most correct answers, whoever got it in first is the winner. So turning in your guesses at the concierge is the very first option. The second is you can email me at mbreaver@eastcastleplace.com. Or you can call my desk at 963-8425. Now, I know I gave you the email address and my phone number way too fast. If you're not familiar with them, call the front desk. They'll give you my email or my phone number, and you can get them into me, and I'll know what date and time that the guesses came in. So there you have it. Again, we have a bottle of wine as our prize this week. I'm sorry I didn't bring it down with me. I think it's a bottle of Chardonnay. But I wouldn't swear to that. But the winner this week will win another bottle of Chardonnay. Again, our sincere congratulations to Teresa Sundberg, our big winner last week. Put those thinking caps on and call in with your answers. Until next week, I ask you all to keep safe. I ask you to be smart, and I ask you to be patient. We'll all get through this together, and then we'll be able to socialize again. That's all for now. I'm Mike Brever, your host of Quick Trivia with Mike. I'll see you again next week.